with me through fire. Heal my disease. I trust in you. Lord, I trust in you. I believe you're my healer. I believe
people. Hi there, welcome to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggy. And Dave is actually in the other room, so we might hear him yell fire sometime. And I have Rachel here with me and Mary Beth with me. And they've been through the different training and healing services that we've had. We started Friday night, Saturday night, and then last night we actually had one at Rachel's home. So thank you. And so we were in Florence, South Carolina. And tell me what town you live in.
Ellabel.
Okay. And now we're in
Cooler. We're in Cooler, Georgia.
Cooler, Georgia. Okay. And then Wednesday we will be in Augusta, Georgia. And then Thursday night we'll actually be going to North Carolina. And where will we be? Do you know, though?
Where?
North Carolina on North Thursday.
Yeah.
Albemarle.
Albemarle. That's
right. Okay. And that will be Thursday and Friday night this week. And so then Saturday night we'll be in Leesville, South Carolina. So we're just kind of like hopping all over the place. God just, he opens the door and we just walk through it. So praise God for the different things that we're able to do, the people that we've gotten to meet. We have had a great time. So, we'll start out with Friday night. What do you remember Friday night, Rachel?
Friday night was the first time we ever met you guys.
Yeah.
Actually ever heard of you guys. Been a wonderful experience just hearing truth, and that's one of the things we were seeking after, was truth, you know, and truth about the word and truth about healing, and we got it.
Well, what happened to you personally?
I've been receiving over the last few days a lot of freedom, a lot of emotional healing, just letting go of a lot of baggage and stuff, and it's you just feel lighter, you feel freer.
Good.
And
praise God. Well, I know we've had a lot of holy laughter.
Yes,
that's throughout these last few days. So that's been good, because people did get set free of different things that they were carrying around, and so that's really been good. And I know you've experienced some of that too, Mary Beth.
I have a lot more freedom. Learned about sonship in a different way, which was awesome. Started ministering for people, which was great. That's my heart. Never had a chance to do that. Didn't feel worthy enough, and I'm finding out that I'm more than worthy and more than capable. And
amen.
That's been a process. And Friday night, I think, the catalyst for what I want to do with that. And it's just showing me all different kind of things. I've seen people in the service just come in and be transformed from the way they walked in the door to how they left on Saturday. It's like you can see the difference in them.
Well, describe that just a little bit.
One of the girls came up after we had been out ministering for the day, which was really fun. If you haven't done that, that's awesome. She came up and you could see the bondage. I mean, she just looked... You could see darkness in her face, and her face was really puffy, and you could see sadness in her eyes, and she just was just so downcast.
Yeah.
And before she left, she was prophesying, and she was seeing pictures, and God was just going, and Jesus, which is awesome. That was the main thing.
And she got filled with the Holy Spirit, too.
Yeah, yes, yay. So Jesus is just going to do a whole work on her, which is awesome. So,
amen.
She prophesied over
She did.
Yeah.
She did. Praise God. Yeah. And, you know, she was just so shy and so quiet and just had a lot of things put her down in life where that was, it was hard for her, but she stepped into it. She just got up there and just joined in with what we were doing. Conference, and so we just did a little bit of that. He wanted to talk about prophecy, so instead of just talking about it, we had people come up and prophesy over one another. Didn't you think that was helpful?
That was helpful, and helped people understand because of the young lady and the friend that was there with her that had never ever done that. So both of them got to actually understand and that sometimes it can just take one word and it means more to somebody than we'll ever know.
Right.
And I think they got that hands-on experience.
Mm-hmm.
And they got to realize they're actually hearing God's voice.
Amen. Yes. Yes. That is important.
Yes.
Some people don't get it, that God's actually speaking to them.
Yes.
And they're supposed to deliver that message to other people so that they can hear God, because maybe they're not hearing Him. Got to use people to speak into your life, and then you realize, wow. And it's just edifying up,
yeah.
And just, it's so cool. So, have you done that much before with prophecy?
I haven't done the training like we did, but I've had word of knowledge and stuff like that for people.
Okay. So, did you think it was helpful to do that training?
I did. Okay. Thank you. Very good. Some of them were scared. And one guy didn't even want to close his eyes. He's like, I can see better when my eyes open.
Yeah.
but he was reluctant at first, but we kind of talked him into it.
Yeah.
But,
well, he said, you don't know if you don't try.
Right.
You know, he could always open his eyes afterwards, but just to try, it's like God wants to stretch us.
Yes.
He wants us to do things that we haven't done before.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, You just never know if you don't do it.
Right. For me, it was the opposite. I always wanted to close my eyes instead of opening my eyes. So God was like, open your eyes. So for him just saying that he couldn't do it with his eyes shut, I was like thinking to myself, well, that's all I ever did. So
usually what I do, but not always. It just depends, you know, what I'm led to do. And sometimes I can just see things or get things with my eyes open.
Mm-hmm.
So... And I usually just start speaking a blessing over somebody. And it's like when you step out, then God meets you where you're at.
Mm-hmm.
And He'll give you more when you step out into it. It's like, you know, you're stepping off a cliff and there's nothing there. And you just take that step. And when you put your foot out, then it's there.
Right.
You know, because yes. God is always there for us. But we just don't always believe that.
Right.
Take that risk.
Right.
So He is always there. And so I love doing that because it just gets people really activated in it.
Mm-hmm.
And just stepping out and just doing God's work. And it's just such a good exercise. It's a safe place there with other people that are doing, maybe they've never done it before, or they may have done it already. And just helping them to realize this is God. Sometimes He'll give you pictures, sometimes He'll give you a word, sometimes you'll just have a knowing. And so, you know.
Or even just one word and then the rest will come as you open your mouth.
Right, exactly. Yeah. So that was Saturday afternoon. What happened when you guys were out Saturday at lunchtime when you were laying hands on people?
It was my first time ever going out, so I was very nervous. But I was matched up with a minister who's done that quite a bit. And he and I went into Walmart, and I mean, right as he walked in the door, it was like, hey, you need prayer today? Let me pray for you. And he's praying for somebody in between the internet door, right in the very lobby of the place. And so we were just kind of led wherever and by the Lord. He would get a feeling of where he felt like we were needed to go.
Mm-hmm.
And sure enough, there'd be somebody there. And then he'd go, okay, well, stop. Now you pray. God, where do we need to go? So at one point, I just kept hearing housewares. And then we went there and all of us were in the California area.
Yeah, at the same time.
Yeah. And then one time we did it in a Herb Photo Center. So we walked around and turned out the photo center was right. All we had to do was turn around and the photo center was right behind us.
Yeah.
But there was a couple there and there she was, and we walked up to her and we asked her if we could, if she said, sure, I'll take it. And I mean, you could just feel the power when we prayed with her.
Amen.
And he's like, man, that was powerful. But God just really set it up, and we were able to see a leg grow out in the lawn and garden.
Amen.
And then we were able to pray with several of the ladies that worked there at Walmart. And it was just awesome to see people who wanted the prayer.
Yep.
Versus the people. Yeah.
We did too.
But it was an interesting experience.
Mm-hmm.
And
so it makes you not so afraid, so you think you can go out and do it again?
Oh, good.
I do.
Good.
Yeah.
Maybe with some more people.
Yeah.
It helps when you have someone who's been through it, but you know they're confident. When you guys know each other, you've been through the training, then yeah, let's go do it again. And yeah, it's just a blast. And once you go do it, then it's like, this isn't so bad. You just got to get activated. That's why we have people go on out with us and going for it, and we see all kinds of things. And once you get a taste of it, it's like almost addictive.
Yeah, it's like you can see things. Yeah. Like we were at a place one night, actually it's Friday night, and our waitress, she seemed like she was carrying the weight of the world on her shoulders. And we not went through the training at that point, so I wasn't really sure how to go, hey, do you need prayer? Can we just pray for you?
Right.
So I just prayed for her from without, you know, actually laying hands on her. But she, I mean, it opened your eyes to see there's more hurting.
Yeah.
It opened your eyes to see that people really are hurting without even actually seeing, you know, or pain, and you can see it on their countenance, and
oh, yeah.
You can see it, and yep. And just knowing that you have the ability to say, hey, just let me pray, and God can do something for you. That really is like the world of difference.
Yeah. So how did you go Saturday?
We were the ones that people ran from us. Or they would say, you had a date with me, yes, yeah, we did.
Yeah,
everybody wants, God bless you, just still pass it on anyway, because I know the Holy Spirit can do it. We don't have to see it. It's going to manifest, and
yeah.
We'll find out in heaven what happens, but that's all right.
Well, I had to say that, but it's funny, but it's not, because it's like, I don't know, but Jesus and Dave seems to be pretty prevalent or something.
Yeah,
and right. So people that don't want Jesus, they just kind of go the other way.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, he sees that happen a lot.
Yes.
And it's not, he tries to make him feel bad, but it's just like, yeah, the Jesus in him, some people don't want anything to do with Jesus. And yeah. So they do. They just, they're on the carpet and
out of there. Yep. Well, I heard the lawn and garden, so we went over there and we were standing there, and nobody was coming around but this lady with the pink shirt. We passed her on the way in, and they just kind of like, okay, well, let's go see if there's someone else, because we're running out of time. So I said, okay, so we turned around, we passed her, she's coming back into the lawn and garden. So I just went up there and I said, can we help you if you need any prayer today? And the husband's like, oh, well, thank you so much. She's like, no, I'm good, thank you. So they kept going.
Oh, no.
So I was just like, well, bless you, have a great day. And I touched her shoulder, so.
You just let Jesus in.
That's right.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, we had a really good time. Not the first time. We had ran into a lady that worked there first, and she had a cane that was in her cart. She was working out of her cart and stuff, and I saw her cane, and I just said, why do you have that cane? What's wrong? You know, people love to talk about it. And so she told me she was going to have a hip replacement. And I just put my hand out and I said, can I pray for you? And, you know, usually when you put your hand out, they give you your hand, their hand. And so she did. And I'm just like, I just speak life into you in the name of Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit. And she said, I said, how's it feel? She goes, I said, move around a little bit. And she moved around a little bit. And she's like, well, the pain went down. I'm like, yeah, that's what we're expecting. And so I put my hand out again to pray for her again, and she didn't give me her hand again. So her hand was on the cart, so I just put my hand on top of her hand, and I just blasted her with the power of the Holy Spirit again. And she's like, wow. She's like, thank you so much. Thank you for praying me. She's like, I love you. And I never met her before. But, you know, it just makes your day when they do that. Yeah. So I know God touched her in a big way, or she wouldn't have said that to a total stranger.
Right.
So then we went to another aisle, and we saw a guy that was on one of those little scooter things. And he had a hat on that said he was a vet. And so we thanked him for being in the service, and we just asked him if he had any pain. Is that why he was on there? And he said, no, I don't have any pain. And he pulls up his shirt and he shows me this big scar all the way down in front of him. He's like, but I'm not in any pain. I'm like, oh, okay. Well, can I pray for you anyhow? And he said, well, sure. And talked to him for a while. And Kareem joined in, and so did Stacy. And he just like, you guys just made my day. And I'm like, oh, thank you. Well, you just made our day by saying that. So, right. You know, it's so cool how you get it. Just interact with the people and just show the love of Jesus. Mm-hmm. Besides healing, of course, or salvation. But they just see Jesus come out of you. And they just always like it. And I have to tell you about Friday night, after the service Friday night, we went to IHOP, International House of Prayer, or Pancakes. And we've been both, but Friday night we were at the House of Pancakes. And we were with Stan, Reverend Stan Shell and his wife, Stacy. And they're the ones that invited us, along with Robert and Chuck and that whole radio group. Praise God. They're awesome. Really neat people. And so Owen Keith, he's the youth pastor at the church.
Yeah.
So I don't want to leave anybody out. So we had a great time with all of them. They're just really fantastic, mighty men of God. So anyhow, we go to the pancake house, and our waiter, he waved, but he got filled with the Holy Spirit that night with the essence of speaking in tongues. And he's like, well, you know, I can't wait till someday I have it. And I said, you already have it. I said, didn't you feel it? And he goes, yeah, I felt it in my stomach. And I said, and you started praying in tongues? Yeah. I said, you have it. And he's like, really? Oh, okay. Then the hostess comes over, and we're ministering to her. And there was a lady there at the tunnels. And so we ministered to those two forever. I think that hostess was maybe like, almost a half an hour talking about God and her experiences and us talking about God. And it was so cool. God just makes those divine appointments. And we were going, was there anybody else? And so they got the lady that had carpal tunnels, and they just blasted her, and it was gone just like that. And she was so excited, all the pain left, and we're like, now you guys can do this, okay? You guys got our cards, you gave everybody a card, and you guys can do this. But, you know, if you need backup, call us. And so they had a really neat group of people at the House of Pancakes. So, well, I guess it's time for a commercial. So hang on, and we'll be right back. Thank you, Ryan.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
I'm Brian Leach, owner of Service Legends, and my position is Chief Talent Officer.
I'm Nicholas Wunderscheid.
I am Bernie Hobbs.
And I'm the Service Manager.
Marketing Director and Client Relations Manager.
Everything that we do is about ensuring that we exceed your expectations.
Our clients are important to us. 100% satisfaction.
We're not just focused on heating and cooling. That's the easiest part of our job, actually, is fixing furnaces and air conditioners.
Everyone that we come in touch with, we want to improve lives.
Bottom line is, we've got our installation guarantees, 25% energy savings guarantee, comfort guarantee, temperature selection guarantee, property protection guarantee.
100% satisfaction guaranteed. Fixed rate's free.
All of those guarantees are backed up with a 100% money back guarantee to hold ourselves accountable to making sure that you get what you're after.
Just fixing the problem today, if they have another problem 5 days down the road, it's still fixed rate or it's free.
We use what's called straightforward pricing. Our technicians are gonna give you an exact to the penny price on what it's gonna take before they move forward with any repair. That way you know what to expect.
It's the same price every day.
No surprises.
If you get off work at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, you come home, you realize that, oh, my furnace is broken. Now you need to call somebody out that night. You shouldn't have to pay more for that.
We're guaranteeing service 24/7.
We run afternoons, evenings, nights, weekends. We're staffed to work that.
Phone rings at 3 a.m. You'll get one of our representatives answering the phone every time.
We're not sending you out to Timbuktu in some call center. It's our service legend team members, our mission control team.
I'll take a call anytime.
And then they answer the phones same way during the day as they do at night.
It's a great day at your service company. How can we make you smile?
That's the only way to provide true 24-hour service.
When you're able to let somebody actually live in their home safely when they weren't able to do that before, where they don't have to stay up at night and worry about, is the heat gonna come back on? Are we gonna freeze the pipes? Is the baby in the room next door gonna be sick because they got too cold? When you're able to help somebody overcome challenges like that, that's impacting a life. That makes a difference. I get goosebumps thinking about it.
I love the team. I love the people that I work with.
We have fun, but we work hard.
I call them my ambassadors of legendary service. If you can just envision what that is, that's who we're sending to your home.
They literally will call in, pick up the phone and call and say, hey, I want to talk to your manager. And I get on the phone, they're like, that technician that was at my house was the greatest technician ever. That's cool to me.
We want to brighten people's days.
Every person that we have going into the house has gone through an extensive background check.
Drug testing. We have a very thorough interview process that 1 out of 140 people make it through.
If we promise you something, that's what you're going to get, no matter what.
We're here when you need us to protect the safety and comfort of your family.
If you're not happy, we're gonna make it right.
If we're willing to put 100% money back guarantee on what we do, what type of work do you think we do?
Give us a call. We're there for you 24/7, 365 days a year.
Enough said.
Hello, friends. I'm Mike Politoski, president of the Spiritual First Responders. Would you like to learn how to heal the sick, how to actually lay hands on the sick and see them recover? I've written a training manual called the Spiritual First Responders Training Manual, and I'd like to see you get a copy of it. For any donation made to hslm.us for $15 or more, we will send you one of these training manuals, and you can learn how to lay hands on the sick and see them recover just as Jesus did in the days when he walked the earth. Endorsed by Dave and Patty, it's the Spiritual First Responders Training Manual. Thank you and God bless you.
Oh, hi. Welcome back. We were just busy talking. Yeah. Hi. I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggy, and we've got Mary Beth here and Rachel here. And praise God, we've had a wonderful time this last weekend. And Dave's still in the other room, so if you hear fire or power or life or something like that, you'll know it's just him praying for somebody over there. Friday night, wow, there was all kinds of stuff that happened Friday night. Do you remember anything besides the one girl?
I remember there's a guy that I prayed for, Chris, that I believe the years past, and one actually completely went away, but he still had a little bit in the other ear. And I believe that the Holy Spirit is going to continue to work on that.
Yes. Amen. Do you remember anything from, I think that was in Greenman.
Yeah. That come from a pattern.
Do you remember anything from Friday night?
Friday night.
There was a lot of holy laughter. I know there was people that were healed of different things. One lady had some.
Yeah.
And her sight was getting better,
yes.
And better,
yes.
And better, but I don't, sometimes
she didn't come back, yeah, so we don't know if she got
her full thing, or we're declaring it.
We don't know when she's going to get it, so she won't get it.
And there was other people that, there was one lady, oh, she came up, she had arthritis. Mm-hmm. And Dave asked if anybody hadn't done this before, prayed for the sick and seen them heal. And so one lady came up, and then that lady came up, and by the time she got up front, she goes, it's already gone. So that's cool.
Yeah.
God does that.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like to see him. To see him doing that, it yeah. just—it was the atmosphere. Totally left. People we fallen down all over the place, being playing in spirit, and God was working on them. Whatever they need, they were getting, and it was just—it was neat. And Kareem, he was just talking about how, oh, I don't know what's going on in here. It's just prophesying everywhere. I've never done this before. It was such a joy to watch and so have been mentoring him, and they're doing a really good job. Praise God.
Yeah.
So he's just really going after it, and you know, he's one of the most eager people that I have ever seen, just really going after it. And his phone was ringing all the time from people that called that wanted him to blast them with the power of the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And so that was really a joy to see somebody that he goes after it.
Yeah.
It is all.
Because you hold on to you too, and you can feel it. It's all shaking.
And it's funny, you'll have to watch it. It was Saturday night. Yeah, I was really mad because there's just all kinds of stuff that happened. Too many pills. And we could overdose, but that was kind of what they were thinking, and so I was really mad because, you know, the devil was just messing with them, and I hate that.
Mm-hmm.
And so anyhow, I just blasted the devil off of them and had the car praying when we first found out, and they were just going after it. There was Kareem in the car, and Christopher and Reverend Stan was in the car, and we're just all going after it. So obviously the devil didn't have a chance.
Yeah.
So praise God.
Yeah.
And they were fine too. I talked to them later that day and then the next day, and they were doing good. So praise God. They went to our house that night and got prayed over. So they just got double dose or whatever. And so, but I was really mad when we got our service.
Yeah.
I was like, I'm going to pound on that dose. And so I was just blasting him and just going after anything and everything, just speaking life into everybody that was in there. Said, you're going to go home healed in Jesus' name.
Yes.
And I said to some of the people that hadn't been to some of the other meetings, I said, I'm just going to show you an example. So I told Kareem to come up, and I grabbed his hands and I just said, in the name of Jesus and the power of the Holy Spirit, I just speak life. And blasted him. He's like shot to the floor like a bullet. And he didn't let go of my hands. So I hit the floor too. Oh my gosh.
He was definitely off her feet.
And Dave sees it. He's in the back by the camera. So he follows. What's going on? Like, I really need that. And he's rolling around. Well, he thought it was sure funny. So, but you know what? When it's God, you don't get hurt.
Right.
It was a hard floor, tile or, I don't know, vinyl, but just on top of cement. It was a hard floor.
Yeah.
And I hit the floor, and thank goodness the microphone didn't even break.
Yeah.
And people of God were like, oh, no, are you okay? And I'm just like, yes, I'm fine. You know, when it's God, he makes way that you don't understand. So I really didn't get hurt. It really didn't hurt me when I hit the ground. It was hard.
Yeah.
So praise God. He just knows how to get her done, get cream what he needs. And I didn't get that. All kinds of guys helping me up. So you'll have to check that out on our meeting from Saturday night. It is kind of funny. Yeah. And I'm sure I'll laugh in this
together. Yeah.
So, but that was Saturday night, and it just got so thick in there Saturday night. People were all over the floor.
Yes.
And it just got, you know, Dave and I don't try to control things. We let the Holy Spirit in and let him do what he needs to do. And different people were coming up, and they got a word. So we're like, well, then he prays for them.
Mm-hmm.
And they was calling different people up and having them pray for people, getting them more activated. And the two young ladies, well, they were on the floor, at least the one was, for a while.
Mm-hmm.
And said, just put your heart on some different people that needed healing in their heart.
Mm-hmm.
And, wow.
Yeah.
I think Kareem hit the floor again.
Yeah. He was like, what are you doing to me? Oh, Lord, I am on fire. What are you doing?
Yep, that was good.
And then when she put her hand on me, all I could do is get hot, and I just laughed. It was just I found out later what he was doing, but he was just talking in a different tongue. That's when I found out that he was curled up all over Dave's feet.
And Dave just looking down like, okay. Oh my gosh, God has a sense of humor.
Yeah, he does.
Did she lay her hands on you?
No.
What's her name? You knew her, Julianne. Yeah, that's who it was.
Yeah.
And Dave told her to put her hands on my heart. And it was just like, I had my eyes closed, and it was just like liquid gold just flowing in to me.
Yeah.
And so that was, there was another one too. Yeah, the two that were good friends that came together. Yeah, that was neat. That was neat. And so, can you have some get here for a minute? You came up, and you were and I don't know, did you notice how they just have some, because you could tell he's crying.
Yeah.
The power of God is just really hitting him, and I don't even know what all you're saying. I don't remember, but wow, God just really touched him when you came up there. Did you notice that?
I didn't notice.
You didn't?
No, I didn't.
Oh, I'll have to show you the picture.
He had your hand on his shoulder, and he was just,
oh, wow.
You could see tears coming down his face.
Glory to God.
And you were just, you just stood there for a minute, and y'all didn't say anything, because you were just like, oh, because you were both feeling it. And then you started giving a testimony about how you met him. And
yeah, okay. Yes.
It really, yeah, when you gave your testimony and just, yeah.
Bless the Lord.
It blessed him in such a big way.
Glory to God.
Yeah, it really did.
And then I think too, it was a combination of how everybody was letting the Holy Spirit do what he, so it was like the combination that just kind of overwhelmed.
Yeah, definitely. And Mike was up there at the same time, Politosky.
Mm-hmm.
And he's the one that, he wrote the book that we use for our healing seminars, that Spiritual First Responders Manual. And so he was there with us, and I know Dave was really getting hit when he came up there, too.
Mm-hmm.
I took pictures of him.
Yeah.
And so that was really neat. I'll have to show you those later. And, yeah, it was good. Tell us some of the things that you saw this weekend.
I saw some pretty neat things. It was kind of crazy. My family, we got there late on the second day, on Saturday. But we went out with some folks after dinner, and we went to an RV park because we're going to go try to grab a bunch of sick people and bring them over to the event. And my daughter, she's 7 years old, and she's just a fun little girl. She's got her own personality, and she's just, you know, like a little really arty singer little girl. And we're walking into the RV park, and Dave and Rachel and Mary Beth are going ahead of us, and they go a different direction. Well, as we're walking, we're trying to go to the middle of the park because there's somebody standing outside. We're going to go talk to them and introduce ourselves, tell them what we're doing. My daughter's like, no, go this way. And so we're like, okay, I can't really say shut your face and sit down because I mean, there's people watching, you know. So, okay, we'll go this way with you. But anyway, no, we let her lead us, and she leads us to a house, and there's like, you know, flowers and a little ramp, but at the end of the ramp there's a gate. And so we were like, I don't want to open the gate, baby. I don't want to open somebody's gate and walk up on their house. Yeah, there's apartments and houses and the RV. So anyway, my daughter decides to go to the apartment next. It's like a duplex style. You know, there's one here and one here. They're connected. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, baby, it's abandoned. There's nobody there. It stinks. You can, you know, it's trashed. And I'm like, there's nobody there. She's like, no, here. And so we go up and knock on the door, entertain her. Like, baby, there's nobody here. We need to go now. She's like, no, we're here. We stay here. I know, baby, we have to go now. She's like, ugh. So I kind of like, we have to go now, baby, okay? We have to go. We're not going to stay now. The dog next door starts barking. And when we get down to the bottom of the steps, the woman who lives next door comes out of her house onto the front porch. And she's a woman of peace. And so she directs us to the manager, who directs us to every sick person in the entire RV park.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, praise God. There's no junior Holy Spirit, you know?
Amen.
And it was really neat. We got to talk to an old guy who, we prayed for him, we blasted him, you know, and he didn't really believe in Jesus. And we were able to give him the gospel, though, you know, and he, like, lives in this RV park secluded. Probably hasn't talked to anybody about Jesus in years. He's been there for over 15 years. And the Lord sent us there to make Jesus an unavoidable issue for him. Yeah, it was really cool. Of course, the event itself, I mean, it was just crazy. People were getting healed. Like, I've never had people fall under my hands in the measure that it happened on Saturday night. It was so, I don't know what was going on, but I knew it was power of God, but I just don't understand how, like, it multiplies. Something happens with, like, the peace of God and the fire of God and combined, and it gets whipped up and it multiplies, and then people are just, like, blacking out. You know, there's this young guy, he plays drums, you know, big guy, bigger than me, big guy, you know. Yep. And I lay hands on him, and I pray for him, and he hits the ground, and he's down there for a minute. And then he gets up, and he's all weak, and he hobbles over, and he hugs me. And while he's hugging me, he starts praying, all of a sudden, Dave comes over, puts his hand on him, and the kid hits the ground again. Wow, and he lays down there for like 20, 30 minutes, you know. And this
our time of the weekend. God had some things to work through with him.
My son.
That was cool.
My son even, like, we brought him to the front to have Dave pray for him. Uh-huh. And he didn't really want to have prayer. He's like, I don't want to fall down. No, please don't make me lay down. A little girl who's fallen out before, and he didn't want to go through it himself. So I don't want to, like, I'm not going down. You can pray for me, but I'm not falling down. So they prayed for him, and he didn't go out. He kind of leaned up against me, you know. And then after they prayed, we prayed for somebody together. Forward, his, like, confidence and everything went off the charts. I mean, he was black and focused, you know, releasing fire. Really, I think a little pain, like, fire, go in Jesus' name. He got activated and it just multiplied. It was just so cool. There was so much stuff going on Friday and Saturday.
There was just it was hard to see everything that happened. God moving in such a mighty way. Everybody just felt the fire of God and the presence of God. And there was a lady that came there that I knew that she she didn't tell me, I just knew from the Lord. And so I just went up and just blasted her. And I asked her husband, I said, do you need prayer for anything? He goes, nope, you just did it right there. And so it was just amazing. And I ended up blasting him too. I'm like, you know what? I want to pray for you too. So if there's anything you need, and he's like, I'm good. You know, I just don't want anybody to go without being touched by the Lord.
Yeah.
Whatever they need that they can get. Yeah. So, well, we got to take another commercial. We'll be right back, and then we can go through some of the pictures that we have from this weekend. So hang on.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
Credit cards are like grandkids. They love you, sometimes get out of control, and it's fun to get a new one. Who can stop them from piling on?
Hi, I'm Tom Coates with Consumer Credit of Des Moines. At the end of the day, you can give these grandkids back, but you're stuck paying off bad credit card debt. We can help you put the fun back into using credit cards responsibly. Right, kids?
Yeah!
If you need help getting credit cards off your back, call Consumer Credit of Des Moines.
Hi, I'm J. Michael McCoy, and about 20 years ago, I went to a used car salesman by the name of John Hewitt. He had a little shop over there on North 2nd Avenue called John's Auto Sales, and I bought a car. I found that experience to be one that I had never had before from a used car salesman. He was honest, he was dependable, he had integrity, and he did what he said he was going to do. Well, over the years, between my kids and grandkids, I purchased 7 vehicles from John's Auto Sales. And last month, I asked him to be a sponsor. I can tell you about their huge selection. I can tell you about their years of experience. I can tell you about their honest integrity. But all I really need to tell you is that I bought 7 cars, and you can trust them. John's Auto Sales, 5435 2nd Avenue, Des Moines.
You need a good ride when you hit the trail. Trust the man with the cars, and he goes by the name of Big John. Big John. Big John.
I was hungry. I was thirsty. I was a stranger. I was naked. I was sick. To the least of these, Holy Spirit-led Ministries is a proud supporter of Impact Ministries International, changing the world together. Find out more at tstammen.com.
Hello, I'm Mike Politoski with Praise Broadcasting Network. For the finest in praise and worship music, visit us at www.pbnradio.com. We at PBN are proud supporters of Dave and Patty Logging, Holy Spirit-led Ministries, and we encourage you to prayerfully consider doing the same. You can visit their website at hslm.us and click the donate button and be a part of helping Dave and Patty reaching out to thousands of hurting people all across the United States of America. You know, the Great Commission of Jesus has no boundaries and no borders, and it takes enormous expenses to move a ministry like HSLM across the country. Would you like to be a part of it? We certainly would appreciate it. Join us in supporting Holy Spirit-led ministries by visiting www.hslm.us and click the donate button. Thank you and God bless you.
Dave and Patty Loggy. Dave's in the other room doing a healing service, and we had Rachel and Mary Beth and so on. And I guess we have a caller, Stan, and I don't know if he needs prayer or what, or I don't know, maybe he was there the other night. So we'll see what Ryan has to say. He's going to talk to him and see if we can do anything for him. But we had audio trouble, so we're doing it by a different way. So we're hoping it comes in better. Sorry about the trouble. So, well, can we put the pictures up, Ryan, and go through those and see what part of what we did this weekend anyhow? There, we're praying for each other, prophesying over each other, and just let people speak into each other, people's lives. Some people haven't done that before, and so it's good for them to be able to practice that, and that's Zoe's daughter in the purple and his wife in the white and green. And there's Dave over there in the corner. And there's Reverend, is it Stan?
Stan.
Oh, okay, well, that might be him that's on the phone. Is it Reverend Stan? Brian? Are you there?
Stan?
Yeah, is it Reverend Stan?
He said you were on a radio program of his. Here, I'll put him on. Stan?
Okay, sure.
Yeah. Hey.
Well, hi, Stan. How are you doing?
Doing pretty good.
Good. Well, what did you think of this weekend?
It was pretty good weekend. this here was the first one that we did with, you know, going out to the streets and healing and stuff. And it turned out real good. And we've got a lot of people saved and delivered. And we had an awesome time this weekend.
Yeah, it was just a blast for us anyhow. To see God move in such a mighty way.
it was pretty awesome. I think
I tell them that's you with the picture that we're looking at. You're wearing a great shirt, so they know who it is that's talking to you. All right.
Okay. Yeah.
Go ahead.
We went to Walmart, and like I said, I've never been to Florence before. This is Chuck's area, and Chuck is wanting to invite the Healing Life, you know, conference down there. So it was kind of new to me, but we went to the Walmart down there and got to pray for quite a few people. I think the lady that's there with you that got to go with me to Walmart, and we prayed for quite a few people. But it was kind of unique because the Lord kind of set up a lot of these interactive things that we got to pray for. It's kind of like He was setting up people for us to pray for, and there was one lady that was sitting at a table, it seemed like she was ready for us to pray for, and I was like, this is kind of unique. I've never saw this before.
God does know how to set things up, doesn't He?
Yeah, what was so unique was everybody else in Walmart was going towards that way, but somehow we ended up getting there first, and the lady said that she actually had surgery, like, I think a day ago. They removed some intestines from her, and she had back pains and all type of things going on with her. And I asked her, I said, "Ma'am, would you mind if, you know, if we could pray for you?" She's like, "Sure." And, you know, first thing I went to was the feet. I was like, "Let me see if your legs are one shorter than the other." And it was. And we prayed for that. We watched the leg grow out to a normal length, and we had her to stand up. Her eyes got big. She didn't say anything. She was kind of like shocked. And she checked her back. Well, she had a brace on, so she wouldn't take it off, but she still said she checked it, and her eyes was big. She's like, "Man, this is real." that's just part of the Holy Spirit moving there, and it's unique just to go out and do that. And that was basically what the conference was about, is to get people out in the marketplace and pray for people, not only the marketplace, kind of like Zoe was talking about, go into the park, you know, the trailer park, the neighborhood, wherever, just pray for somebody and just touch people in Jesus' name. That's what it's all about.
Yeah. Amen. Praise God. Yeah. We had a ball going out and about praying for people, and I know some people have never done that before, and it really helps activate them so that they could really do it in real life with somebody else who had done it before, and that just gave them the confidence so that they can go out again and do it again. And when you see something happen, you see God move, it's like, wow, I want to see this again. It's like you can't help but want to do it. And it does open your eyes, like Rachel said. You see people, not just the ones with the canes or the little scooters or the walkers, but you can see the pain on people's face. And so you want to touch them. You want to see God move on them so they're healed. So can we go through some more of those pictures, Ryan? That I've got. Dan will probably be in some more of those, too. That's where we're prophesying over each other or praying for each other. You can kind of tell on that picture. Dave didn't have his eyes all the way open. He was, like, crying because God was just touching him when you were up there. There's Cream, the one that grabbed my hand and pulled me down. That was a new one for me.
That was kind of unique when the power of God hit the conference pretty strong. It hit later the first night it hit during the service, and then it hit again later on Saturday night, our last session that we had. And it hit Dave pretty hard. And I know my wife, he called my wife up to pray for her, and the power of God hit her, and it kind of reworked her. She's like, you know, I feel different. you know. So it was kind of cool because he's like, does anybody else want to touch a God? I said, I want to touch whatever that is. I went up there and grabbed his hand. it was unique. And it really touched everybody there. And I'm going to tell you something that I saw in the spirit when I was there. When all this was going on, I saw something big and white floating over the whole thing. There was an angel in there flying around, dude. There was angels involved in that. I mean, they was there. So, you know, the hand of God was touching in that place. And I talked to Robert Hager, which is one of our ministers on our staff, and he said that he felt like, you know, there's a lot of change happening in his life and a lot of things that he's been wanting happen. And it was awesome. I mean, it was just an awesome night there.
Good. We sure do like doing God's work and seeing him move. Can we flip through some of those other pictures too, Ryan? Oh, there's your wife and your daughter. Oh, that's Robert right there. He's the one that he did some of the music, and that's Dan there on the right. And oh, that was Chuck.
That was
okay.
The two girls that came and had ever. One got saved.
Yeah.
And the other one, they both prophesied it for the first time. And
yeah. And there's Dan's wife, Stacy, and your son, Skylar, and the back of your wife, and Kareem again. Oh, there's the guy, Christopher.
Yeah.
But his ear got better. He had the ringing done in one. There's Rachel. And then on the right, that's the guy that played the drums. What was his name?
Yeah, Wesley. Yeah,
that's a good name. So.
Yeah. Chuck told us, he said, if he don't wake up, y'all got to pick him up and carry him home. So.
We did have to pick up his drums.
Yeah, I'm like, man, I hope he wakes up.
How convenient he got slain in the spirit when it's time to pack up.
Yeah. And I know right when I was getting ready to take down the poster, Zoe grabbed me, started praying for me, and I started falling down. I said, man, I said, I gotta get up on that ladder. You better be a little careful there.
I'm gonna tell you
one thing that happened to me and my wife when we was going home Sunday evening. Sunday morning, I'm sorry. But we was going home, and the spirit hit us in the vehicle. We was sitting there just talking about what happened at the event, and all of a sudden, I started laughing. Well, first of all, Stacy, my wife was talking about, you know, her laying hands on people. She's kind of shy of doing that, you know, and I told her, I said, you're going to have a bit of problem praying for anybody anymore. And all of a sudden, I started laughing, and then she started laughing. We ended up laughing for 15 minutes in the car going down the road. We
couldn't stop.
Oh, that's cool. That's cool.
It was awesome, man. I mean, the spirit was still on everybody. And then I think later that night, me and Robert went out to eat right after the service. And we was talking to him and his wife, and his wife kind of, you know, she don't like to be put out in public at much. And they was like, you know, are you going to pray for more people? She said, yeah, I'm going to try to. But the presence was so strong on those two that I knew something's going to happen to them. I mean, I knew that the presence was going to start working on her.
Amen.
I mean, everybody came out with something on them. And I'm going to tell you something else. People had gold on them. I saw gold on people's eyes.
Oh, cool. Yeah. I didn't see that. Praise God.
Yeah, so it was some unique things happening there at night. I mean,
You saw them before now, didn't you?
Well, cool. It's like when Julianne was praying for me, she had her hands on my heart, and so did her friend. It's like my eyes were closed. I just saw liquid gold just going right into my heart.
Wow.
It was just like, oh, thank you, Jesus. It's just born into me.
Lord.
So that was cool. I should tell her that. I didn't tell her that. There was just so much going on. And, of course, when she's praying for me, I'm just receiving it. I'm not going to be talking. Well, we don't have much time yet, but we have to pray for people. We don't want to get praying for people. So I'm going to start out, and then if you want to jump in, Mary Beth and Zoe. If you got anything, Reverend Stan, we gotta do this quickly because we're about out of time. But okay. I just want to look up. I got a message from grandparents, a text message. Baby William and Alina, they're doing better in some things, but not in others. So I just want to lift them up right now. I just speak healing and wholeness now in Jesus' mighty name, that they're going to walk in divine health, that they're going to have everything functioning properly in Jesus' mighty name, that they're not going to have any tubes sticking in them. They're just going to be healthy and whole, nothing to help them. Their body function is just going to function properly in Jesus' mighty name. I just lift up our friend that had problems on Saturday, that she's just going to know who she is in Christ, and she's just going to burst wide open in doing the work of the Lord in Jesus' name. And I just declare the people that are going to come to the Iowa State Fair and help, and we're going to see more miracle signs and wonders than we did last year. We just thank you, and we just lift up Laura and Philip in Jesus' mighty name that they are healed and whole now. Amen.
Father, we just thank you for the time that we've had this awful weekend. Thank you for the divine hookup, Lord. Father, we just praise you and we glorify you, and I just thank you for everyone that you touched, Lord, and I'm looking forward to doing things for you and for the kingdom, and I just praise you and glorify you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
All of you out there, you guys just be blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen. 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 Go ahead, Dan.
I'm feeling that somebody's having issues. I don't know where the enemy is messing with them, but I command that thing to break off of them in Jesus' name. I command you to leave, and you go back to where you come from in Jesus' name by the power of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, you have to leave now. You have to leave off of their body. You have to leave off their mind now in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, I ask you just to hit them with power right now. Right now in Jesus' holy name. And so it is.
Amen. Amen. Well, wow. I only have a couple minutes left. You got a minute, Dan? You want to tell a testimony or something else from this weekend?
Like I said, everybody experienced something. You know, I'm sure. I mean, I saw some of the ladies there that was experiencing a lot of stuff that I don't even think they even walked in before. And you're talking about Kareem. He's never had prophecy before. He picked the gift of prophecy opened up on him, and he was just going wild with it. I mean, it was awesome how that opened up on
him. Amen. Amen. God was in control Saturday, all weekend. He was in control. We just let the Holy Spirit have his way, and he sure did. He did a great job, and he just used everybody in there. If people haven't seen the video from Friday night or Saturday night or during the day, all the way through it, you can just see the Holy Spirit moving and people just stepping into what God had for them. You know, we're not the boss. We're not in charge. The Holy Spirit is. We pull people up and we have them praying one for another. And just seeing God move in such a miraculous way.
Even last night. We had another meeting after the weekend meeting.
Yeah.
Rachel's husband.
Yeah.
He got that same power, whipped him right up in prophesying. I mean, he prophesied so powerfully.
Amen.
He prophesied, started weeping. We all started, we felt God's presence come so powerfully.
Amen.
It was awesome.
Yes, it was.
And he's never done that before.
Jesus. Yeah. And the lady that we prayed for last night. Her husband's here tonight. Praise God. God can move mountains, can't he? When we're there and we're declaring over it, we see it happen.
Yeah.
Well, I just want to thank everybody that was on tonight. We've had a great show, and I know Dave's had a great time over there in the meeting because I can hear him from time to time. We always do. Praise God. So we want to thank you, Stan, and the rest of the crew for having us there in Florence, South Carolina. And we will be back. So thank you so much. And we just want to bless all of you, and we just want to say thank you to everybody who we got to meet this weekend, stepping into what God has for them. And we want to thank those that donate into our ministry, and just our team that is back at home holding the fort down while we're gone. Thank you so much, everybody, for all they're doing. And we just want to say thank you, Jesus. God, we just thank you that all the things that we get to do and see and just walk in all that you have for us, because it would never happen without you. So we will see y'all next week, same time, same place. God bless.
With me.